This is Coyote with the Azure Monitor team. In this video tutorial, I'll walk you through the process of creating action rules to dynamically connect action groups at scale across multiple alerts or to suppress notifications generated by alerts during periods of planned maintenance. There are three main use cases for defining action rules. First, it's often useful to connect the same actions to multiple types of alerts. For example, I may want to send an SMS to the on-call staff for all critical alerts in my subscription, or I may want to email the DevOps team for all alerts generated by my Application Insights resource. The second use case for action rules is to suppress alert notifications during maintenance windows and non-business hours. During these suppression periods, alerts will still be fired, but the corresponding notifications and actions will not trigger. Lastly, some alert sources do not let users connect action groups to them directly, so action rules can be used here to add action groups to these alerts. Now I'll show a couple of examples of creating action rules. In the first scenario, I want to assign the same webhook action to all Sev0 and Sev1 alerts across an entire resource group. I'll start by clicking on Azure Monitor and navigating to Alerts. Next, I'll go to Manage Actions and select the Action Rules tab. I can now move on to New Action Rule to start defining my criteria. First, I'll set my scope. I'll start with selecting the subscription, then selecting the resource type, which for this demo will be resource group, and lastly, choosing the resource. Once the scope is selected, I'm presented with links to existing alert rules and action rules that match the same scope. This provides a great opportunity to sanity check which other alert rules and action rules may take effect. Moving on to filter, filter gives me the option to choose a subset of alerts by specifying additional criteria, such as severity, condition, description, and others. In this case, I'll stick to severity. Now I'll choose the type of action rule. This can be action group or suppression. I'll be using action group for this demo. You may choose to use an existing action group or create a new one. I'll use an existing webhook that makes an HTTP call to a third-party system. Now I'll provide a name and description for my action rule. And action rules are just like any other Azure resource and need to be saved in a resource group. So let's do that now. In this second example, I'd like to suppress the notifications and actions from all alerts on my VMs because I'm about to roll a patch out to one of my applications. During this time, my app will be down and the VMs will be restarted, and I don't want my ops team to receive false alert notifications. I'll start once again by clicking on New Action Rule and specifying my desired criteria. First, I'll set the scope by choosing the subscription and setting the resource type to virtual machine. But this time around, I'll use suppression as the type of action rule, and I'll schedule it from today at noon to tomorrow at 1 p.m. It's also important to note here that I have the option to choose whether I want to enable suppression from now until I manually disable it, or to set it up for a specific date and time in the future, or even choose a recurring time period based on daily, weekly, or monthly frequency. Next, I'll supply a name and description for my action rule. And again, since the action rule is a standard Azure resource, I also need to select a resource group in which to save it. Finally, the Enable Rule Upon Creation option gives me the flexibility of creating these action rules ahead of time and enabling them or disabling them on the fly when necessary. However, since I've already defined a fixed time period for this rule, I'll go ahead and enable it now. Once the action rules have been defined, I can view whether they were used to fire my alert or suppress any notifications. To do this, I'll return to the main alerts blade in Azure Monitor and click on Total Alerts. This shows a table listing all my alerts and the associated information. I can now add the suppression status column to the table, and this shows me whether or not the action groups for this alert were suppressed. Alternatively, I can check the alert history to view the impact of action rules. I'll click on a single alert and switch to the History tab. In this tab, we can see all the action groups that were applied and their source. In this example, we can see that one action group came from the alert rule and another action group was added by an action rule. Please keep in mind that suppression rules take precedence if they overlap with any actions. Hopefully, this has given you some insight into how action rules are a useful addition to the alerting capabilities of Azure Monitor. Thanks for watching this short tutorial. Remember, you can take advantage of action rules to define actions at scale and to suppress alert notifications and actions during maintenance windows.